हेलो, दिस इज स्वप्निल ममानी, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर, आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस, महिला महाविद्यालय तासगांव। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। C++ वेरिएबल्स। C++ वेरिएबल्स आर कंटेनर्स फॉर स्टोरिंग डाटा वैल्यूज। इन C++ देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वेरिएबल्स डिफाइंड विथ डिफरेंट कीवर्ड्स। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इंटीजर stores integer without decimals such as 1 2 3, 5 6 7, -1 2 3, -55, like that. Second type is double, stores floating point numbers with decimals such as 19.99, 20.50, -20.50, like that. Third is character type, stores single character such as A, B, capital Z, capital X, small Y. Character values are surrounded by single quotes. Fourth type is string, stores text such as hello world. String values are surrounded by double quotes. Last is bool, stores values with two states, only two states, true or false. Declaring or creating a variables. To create a variable, you must specify the type and assign it a value. Syntax: type variable equal to value semicolon, where type is one of C++ type such as integer, and variable is the name of the variable such as x, y, a, b, or anything like that. The equal sign is used to assign values to the variable. To create a variable that should store a number, look at the following example. Example is create a variable called my number of type integer and assign it to the value 15. Means integer my number equal to 15. Next statement is cout insertion my number. Output of this program is 15. Assigning value. You can also declare a variable without assigning the value, or assign the value later. For example, integer my number semicolon, my number equal to 15 semicolon, cout insertion character my number semicolon. Output of this program is similar to the previous program. Note that if you assign a new value to an existing variable, it will override the previous value. For example, integer my number equal to 15. Now my number is 15. Next statement, my number equal to 10. Now my number is 10. When we print this statement like cout my number, then output is of this program is 10. Other types to declare the variables like integer my number equal to 5, double my float number equal to 5.99, character my letter equal to D, string my text equal to hello, bool my boolean equal to true. Display variables. The cout object is used together with the insertion operator to display variables. To combine both text and a variable, separate them with the insertion operator. For example, integer my age equal to 35. Cout insertion operator im, insertion operator my age, insertion operator years old. We have seen here im and my age is separated by insertion operator. add variables together. To add variable to another variable, you can use the plus operator. For example, integer x equal to 5, integer y equal to 6, integer sum equal to x plus y, cout sum. Output of this program is 11. Declare many variables. To declare more than one variable of the same type, use a comma. For example, integer x equal to 5, comma y equal to 6, comma z equal to 50. Cout x plus y plus z. Output of this program is 61. C++ identifiers. All C++ variables must be identified by unique names. These unique names are called identifiers. Identifiers can be short names like x, y, z, abc, or more descriptive names like age, sum, total volume, etc. Note that it is recommended to you to use descriptive names in order to create understandable and maintainable code. For example, when we declare integer minutes per hour equal to 60, that is a good declaration. But it's okay when we declare integer m equal to 60. Not so easy to understand what m actually is. So we have to declare descriptive names. There are general rules for constructing names for variables. First is, names can contain letters, digits, and underscores. Second is, names must begin with a letter or an underscore, not an digit. Third, names are case sensitive. Like my var, here v is a capital, and my var, when v is small, they all are different variables. Fourth, names cannot contain white spaces or special characters like exclamation mark, hash, percent, etc. Last, reserved words like C++ keywords such as integer, float, boolean cannot be used as names. C++ constants. When you do not want others or yourself to override existing variables values, use the constant keyword. This will declare the variable as a constant, which means unchangeable and read only. For example, constant const integer my number equal to 15. My number will always be 15 due to this line. On the next line, when we declare my number equal to 10, it will occur error. Assignment of read-only variables, my name. You should always declare the variable as a constant when you have values that are unlikely to change. For example, const constant integer minutes per hour equal to 60. That will never ever change. So we can use constant variable for this type of variables. Next example is constant float pi equal to 3.14. That will never ever change. At the end of this lecture, we'll learn last point, C++ user input. You have already learned that cout is used to output or print values. Now we will use cin to get user input. Cin is a predefined variable that reads data from the keyboard with the extraction operator. The extraction operator is double greater than sign. Let's see the example. The user can input a number which is stored in the variable x. then we print the value of x. Example is integer x semicolon cout insertion operator type a number semicolon press enter. Cin extraction operator x semicolon. In this line, get the user input from the keyboard. Next line is cout insertion operator. Your number is insertion operator x. This line displays the input value which is given by the user from keyboard. Let's see the simple addition program. In this example, the user must input two numbers, then we print the sum by calculating the two numbers. The example is integer x comma y, integer sum. Sum is additional variables we have declared here to save the addition of these two numbers, which is x and y. Cout type a number. Cin extraction operator x. Cout insertion type another number. Cin extraction y. Sum equal to x plus y. Cout sum is sum. This displays the addition of x and y. To get the more videos of this series, please like, share and subscribe. And please do not forget to press the bell icon to view latest videos. Thank you.